Thank you that I can post you this question. Yesterday you already answered all my questions and this morning too, but I have one more. One more question is it really necessary to be rebirthed?
It depends upon how much file you have cleared. If file remain pending, then you have to come again. And if you finish all files with equanimity, practicing five principles more than 70%, then one life will there, only one life. And then ultimate salvation.
Okay, thank you very much.
I have a question concerning the fault is of the sufferer. The situation is when my sisters and I visit my mother, I don't have any conflicts with my sisters, but I feel that my mother doesn't like me. I think that she doesn't realize how she behaves towards me and that she neglects me. I don't have any conflict with my brother or my sister. It's always with my mother. My sister also notices this, and I don't want to offend her. I don't want to hurt my mother. My sister says, "Why don't you tell her?" But I don't want to offend my mother. I don't want to hurt her.
So this is your sticky file. Sticky file.
When I drive home, I feel very sad and I feel like crying. But my mother, she doesn't feel anything.
Now you start, ask Garuda to do pratikaman. File 1, Garuda. And see mother inside Rainezile and outside relatively she is mother of Garuda. Ask Garuda to do pratikaman. Keep positive opinion and whatever negative thoughts, negative opinion, do pratikaman for that. And every day, at least 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, do pratikaman from morning till night, what mother has done with Garuda. Any negative things happen, you ask Garuda to do pratikaman. You try for 1 month, continuous, 1 month medicine.
Dankeschön.
And if it is helpful, then continue that medicine.
Jai Sachidanand?
Yes.
The topic of discharging karma is not clear to me yet. It feels like being passive. Can Francesco discharge his karma while still having, still taking decisions, still having wishes and all that?
That discharge karma itself will make you have all kinds of activity, and it will not make you passive at all. It will not allow you to be passive at all. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
When you get up in the morning, you feel like going to the restroom, so the discharge karma will make you go. And then you will, because of the discharge karma, you will feel hungry, so you'll again run for eating. Then you will have the need for money, so your discharge karma will make you earn money. So it will not allow you to be passive, this discharge karma.
Really, Francisco should be busy with scientific circumstantial evidence. And you are inactive, non-doer. You are nowhere and seer what Francisco is doing. So you should not do anything, and Francisco must do everything. You understood?
It means.
Does that mean that from the point of Gnanvidi, everything is discharging karma, and we don't have any? But we don't charge new karma.
Nay, if you practice five principles, then you can stop charging new karma. So that is, we want to make real effort now to stop charging new karma. Otherwise, Due to ignorance, whole worldly people, they are charging new karma automatically due to self-ignorance. And here you are getting self-realization and you are getting who is the real doer, scientific circumcision. That awareness with that, oh, this is file, we have to solve it equanimity, Francisco is relative, I am real. And whatever Francisco is doing is a result of scientific circumstantial evidence. That by practicing five principles, you can stop charging new karma. And that is real effort. Every moment we have to do real effort for stopping new karma. You understood?
I understand. Thank you.
Jai Sachidananda.
Thank you for answering my question. So my question is, after mind, speech and body have left, and there's just the essence of a pure soul left, where does this pure soul get its energy or its strength from?
No, it is full of infinite energy. It is naturally, it is, means soul is a full of energy, full of infinite energy, full of infinite bliss, full of infinite knowledge, full of infinite reason. But due to covering, we are not getting benefit of that energy. Yesterday in Jnanvidhi, some part of that wrong belief has broken. Now energy, now it will uncovered, we are uncovering that energy. So it is full of energy. It is naturally,
its very property, its very nature is full of energy, the soul. Just like a piece of gold does not have to have any energy to remain a piece of gold, in the same way, the soul does not have to have external energy to be energetic. It is already full of infinite energy. Because of ignorance and attachment and abhorrence, this infinite energy was covered with a curtain or veil of ignorance, and now as we follow this Jnana and we decrease our attachment and hatred, this veil of curtain or veil of ignorance will lift and we can experience that infinite energy.
Understood?
I wrote down four questions, but I choose only two because actually these two questions are just one. So, my question is about intuition. Is there intuition in life? Do we have an inner voice?
See, both are the separate things. Inner voice is different.
So intuition is a result of previous karma.
And we can say two things. One is intuition and one is vision.
So suj or intuition is the direct light of the soul. If you are sitting with steadiness and all of a sudden from inside there will be an intuition of the solution, that is called intuition and it is the direct light of the soul. And according to the different levels of development, at each level, each living being does have a certain amount of intuition that comes up. Even a small little puppy, if it is walking on the edge of the wall, and it notices that it will fall down if it goes any further, and the intuition will tell it to turn back.
So intuition can come from our pure soul, but it's depending on our level, how...
Yeah.
Yes, it is coming from the soul, but depending on what developmental level you are at, to that extent, the intuition will come up for that person.
So can we trust this intuition? Is it good for us? So guess I'm at a lower level. Is it still good for me to trust my inner voice?
For sure, most definitely you should listen to your intuition, because what happens to us most of the time is that from the intuition comes up the ego, and from the ego comes up the intellect, and then we move forward listening to the intellect, and we are suppressing our intuition, unfortunately. And in the external outside world, everybody is recommending to increase the intellect only. Nobody is encouraging to increase the intuition, unfortunately.
You understood?
Yeah, I understand. And how can I distinguish the voice of my intellect from the voice of my pure soul?
If it is showing good and bad, if it is showing the faults of others, then understand that it is the voice of the intellect. Now, there are three parts to this: the intellect, the heart, and the soul. Now, heart is related to what you are calling the intuition, and the soul is represented by the prajna shakti, that which separates out the temporary and the permanent is called the prajna shakti. And what is heart? It looks after the benefit of the entire group of the community, not for some selfish benefit and getting benefit for ourselves and disbenefit to the entire community. Not like that. That part comes from the heart. It is called heartily, and it is linked to intuition. And intellect is showing profit and loss, good and bad. It shows duality. The additional function of the intellect is to take decisions.
You understood?
Okay, understand, yes. And so the thing is, for example, here in Bavaria, you believe in a garden angel. So, and some people think this garden angel is your inner voice. Is it right?
For the most part, all of this is mainly imagination, oftentimes. Oftentimes, it is exaggeration and imagination. The celestial beings, the angels, usually they do not interfere and guide about all these routine worldly matters.
You understand?
Okay, understand. Thanks.
Yeah, Gloria.
I'm new to this path, and I read or heard that we are not supposed to hurt any living being. So my question is, if you have a disease, then fighting the bacteria is also hurting a living being. The doctor does it. The doctor gives you medicine to kill the bacteria.
Then you can take the medicine.
No problem.
And the second question is also related. If, for example, I have a spider in my home or in my room, do I have to let them be?
You have to catch them in a plastic bag and throw them outside.
And the next question is about Jesus Christ and his karma. He said that he is God or the Son of God. Then dying in such circumstances, was that paying off his karma?
Yeah, definitely. Karma is a result of karma.
Internally, he was God. Externally, everybody has to go through the results of their karma. Lord Krishna also had to, and Lord Ram also had to, and similarly Jesus Christ also.
Understood?
Vielen Dank.
I think we'll do 15 minutes samayik. This is special introspection program to see our own fault and wash out our fault by pati command. And which type of fault we have to wash out from childhood till today? We have so many people comes in contact in childhood: brother, sister, father, mother, then friends in college or school and college, friends in business, some colleague, manager, boss, assistant. So in relation with people, we may hurt each other. So we will see our own fault in samayik, means introspection. And then we will keep separation with file one. I am pure soul. File one is separate. And whatever mistake done by file one, he has to realize, he has to accept, he has to wash out by pratikaman. So 10-15 minutes this experiment we will do from childhood till today. how many people we have in contact to whom we hurt. No, one lady said that her mother, age of 72, she has problem with mother. So due to childhood, some negativity, negative opinion given to the family member, and that negative opinion will be always disadjustment between two, and positive opinion is adjustable with each other. So that negative part we want to wash out. If you hurt or say negative thought, negative speech and negative action which hurt other person, that part we want to wash out. By anger we hurt other person, by pride we may hurt other person, with deceit or greed we may hurt other person, with more expectations somebody may feel, may not fulfill our expectations, we may hurt others by speech or say thoughts or say action. Jealous is also competition, jealous, we may hurt, or say we cannot hurt verbally, but by thoughts we may hurt others. So we will find out which are the sticky file in our life and to whom we hurt. So we will find out, we will visualize what happened with which people, what happened and to whom we hurt. We find out and we will do pratikraman, we will visualize inside pure soul and we'll ask whatever mistake done with their file, physical part, and we will ask for forgiveness and keep separation of pure soul and file one separate. So I think everybody can understand this to whom we hurt. It is very easy to understand. And now important part, we have to do pratikraman and keep separation, and file one has to do pratikraman. That part it is important. So from childhood we will see all our faults and we will do pratikraman for that. So we will start doing pratikraman 10-15 minutes. Everybody, this understanding is clear? Yes or no?
The last part of the Charanvidhi book, it is mentioned in detail as to how to do pratikraman, but for right now, we are going to do it in a very short way, simple way, not the detailed way like it is mentioned in the back of the book. Very simple. O pure soul within the other person, I apologize for having hurt you and give me the strength not to do this again, and I apologize for having hurt you. That's all. Has it ever happened that you have hurt others in your entire life? If there is anyone who has not hurt anyone at all in their entire life, please raise your hand.
Oh, so
nobody.
Nobody. I have also hurt so many people. But only solution is to do pratikraman. So we'll do pratikraman. And this is only sample for 20 minutes, 15 minutes. In future, every day you can spend time 15 minutes, 20 minutes. For whole day you find out to whom we hurt and do pratikraman for that. So that will help you to clear our files with equanimity. And once we solve our whole files, we'll free for our salvation. So our ultimate goal, we want to come out from all this sticky file. We want to wash out our mistake with sticky files. And when we see fault of others, that karmic account will increase. And we see our own fault, file one's fault, and other people as a faultless, then we will speedily, we can resolve our files with equanimity. So now we will start special prayer for Samayik, and we will take blessings of Dada Bhagwan.
Jai Sachidanand. Mm-hmm. Please repeat with me. Close your eyes and repeat with me. O Sri Simandar Swami Prabhu, please give me strength to see where vile one has hurted others and do pratikaman for the same. I surrender my mind, body, speech, and all karmas into the lotus feet of Simandar Swami and Dada Bhagwan.
Find out to whom we hurt and do pratikamana and keep separation with vile one. You are as a pure soul, knower and seer.